Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more disclaimer,
Ira Epstein,
hit the pause key on your
with
video
your morning flash update for an interesting Thursday. And this is the 16th of November, 2017 at 9:20 a.m. Central Standard Time. You're getting a rally in the stock market because in part today we're going to see the president head up to Capitol Hill, deal with the House of Representatives, give them the old 1-2 cheer, and try to get them to push through their version of the tax bill. We then hope that we see some movement in the Senate on a tax bill where you bring back in, I think it was Ron Johnson from Wisconsin, he wants to come back in, so he needs changes, Sue Collins, John McCain, there's a bunch of people. I wrote last night in my consultancy report, and that's what I want to call my research, my consultancy report, how this is going to impact the markets, and it's happening just the way we thought. Anything positive lifts the stock market, brings the dollar back up at the expense of the euro. Metals will sit and wait and see what's going to happen. You're going to see that on the energy markets, while the gasoline is dropping down, we're moving to the Jans on everything, by the way, so you'll see that later today. You're pretty stable here at the $55 mark. Grain still underselling pressure. Now, there's a strong seasonal that hits in the soybean market, especially between now and mid-December, that prices from the 16th of Nov generally are higher. Doesn't mean it has to be, but they're generally higher by the middle of December. And that's because the, let me get it right, the hedging pressure comes up. What can you say? Another thing before I go through into the daily stuff. I know a lot of you go to our website. On Friday afternoon, we're going to start taking down our website and putting up a whole new look to it. I don't mean just new pictures. It's going to have a whole new look to it. Then I'll be adding videos to it. And remember those libraries I told you where I'm going to be bringing in, like pivot points that we had done, and I'm going to be adding more to those? This is the beginning of when I'm going to start doing all that. And then coupling with that over time, I'm going to start going back to live webinars right after the first of the year. This has just taken an awful long time for us to get done, so a lot more coming to you for 2018. So let's take a look, if we can, at what we've got. The National Association of Home Builders came out with an index of 70. That's still strong. They expected 67. That's good. The IEA today, that's the International Energy Agency, reported that over the next decade that the U.S. will account for 80% of the worldwide crude oil production growth. That's a big number. And they also predict that the U.S. is going to produce in that time 30% more gas than Russia, which means we will become a monster exporter of liquid nitrified gas. In the jobless claims today, they were up 10,000 to 249. They were expecting 235. The Federal Reserve U.S. production and capacity utilization, industrial production up 9/10. That's a good number. Then if you take a look at the utilization, up 77%, another increase, an increase in the September numbers. So everything there is still looking good. I see nothing to take the Fed off the December rate hike mode. The Philly Fed Business Index headlines, they came in like the Empire State, weakening in most categories. And if you look at it, you'll see prices received, 88.6. You can just go through them. I don't have to read them each to you. But a bit of a weakening there. U.S. import and export headline recaps. Well, import prices were up 2/10. They expected up 4/10. We're not importing the inflation. Export prices were up 1/10. The prior was up 8/10. So that's about where it was. Petroleum import prices, though, this was surprising because prices have gone up. The prior month was up 4.5. You're only up 1.7. Australia's unemployment rate pegged at 5.4, slightly lower than the 5.5 the economists had expected. Retail sales in the UK during October rose 3/10 from September, better than the forecast of a 1/10 rise. However, sales in October 2017 were off 3/10 from the previous year, and they expected annual sales off 4/10. Last, Eurozone core CPI off a tenth on the month-to-month basis, while the core CPI in October was positive 9% from 2016. This should keep the Eurozone from doing anything rash, but their programs are probably going to continue on, as we've heard. Consumer price index was up a tenth month-to-month basis, in line with expectations. So we're not getting any shockingly bad data out of that, is the important part. Now, we're going to be writing about a lot that's going on right now. You do realize what an important time frame you're in exactly as I'm talking to you. This is tax time. What gets done? How's it going to impact these different markets? We're going to cover them. I'm covering them now in great detail in my reports. Lynn puts out a series of different reports. We were talking about it. By 8 in the morning this morning, we had 75 research reports out just on the commodity markets today. 75 by 8 a.m. And you can pick the different categories of markets you want to get them in. They're dumped into your mailbox. Or if you get our charting platforms, and we offer free trials, and a lot of you are subscribers to them, it's right in them for you, so you don't have to go searching around everywhere. Give us a call. You can go to our website. You'll see a carousel of free offers. Give us out any of our free trials. We'll make sure you get this. You can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube, or underneath us. It says click here for Ira's free offers. Do so, and away we go. I'm Ira Epstein. Let me hear from you, and you have a great trading day.